Wait, where am I? Is you guys got me in one of these bad dreams, don't you? Is this what I think? This you guys put me in the Titanic?
Well, I'll fix this, huh,
Leo? What are you saying in my ear? Oh, Bitcoin, it's gonna crash. What?
And honestly, if you guys came to this video for good news, you've come to the wrong place. Today, we are filming on the Titanic. We have Tesla. I am so sorry. I just want to preface this. Bitcoin, I'm really even more so sorry. And today is the day that I wish would never come, but it has to come. We have stocks. And also, just to let you guys know, I know sometimes, actually all the time, not sometimes, all the time, ADHD, like I go from story to story and I'm like, oh, look, a squirrel. And then I am so sorry. But I did want to talk about how stocks could be volatile in the week ahead. But I know you guys also, too, you don't make it through the whole video. So I have to, like, I hop around. I'm like, okay, I think they'll get everything. But I want to show you something about Bitcoin that is frightening. I mean, besides just looking at this chart, what happened? It's like, no, we have plenty of support over here. Bravo, look, we got it. Hey, kids, this isn't what I wanted to do. And in about 3 hours, you guys are going to paint yourself a full candle underneath the EMA 13, the 21, the 34, and the 200-day moving average. So if there was an ever, I told you so moment, I'm not telling you so, the Titanic hit an iceberg, okay? I know, you know, they're still, but bravo, there's still music playing. Like this thing's the ship that never sinks. Here on the MACD on your weekly, that was your, right there. It was like, you know what, kids? This isn't looking good, all right? We got so much strength to the downside. This, in 3 minutes and 27 seconds, is going to close a candle. This is below. I know you got a lot of price action in there. Just look. you have your 200 and all your EMAs were closing underneath. It's not good. Also, a pinch for good measure. It looks like, the news already has it. Bearish death cross patterns loom for both Bitcoin and what? U.S. stocks. I mean, on Bitcoin, you still got some time, right? There's just all those indicators that start popping up that's like, hey, guys, I get it. If you want to just buy and hold, feel free. I mean, there are times to enter a market. There are times to exit a market. There's times that you definitely don't want to buy. There's times that you want to short if you guys want to leverage short. I mean, these are all opportunities. But on the Bitcoin, I mean, you got a while. I mean, a death cross, that, see this purple line? I turned it nice and purple for you. Purple nurple. Once these two cross, you know, probably right in July, maybe August. It just depends on how violent you want to be. Also, if this looks confusing to you, I offer a course on all of this. If you want to learn how to not lose so much money, okay? I cannot promise to you that you will make money because I would be lying to you. But looking at this, also, deep discount, right? Is that what you have to say? Deep discount. Link in the description. If I were to just fix this for you so you'd know when was the time? Now, a lot of people are like, time to buy. Buy the dip. No, buying the dip. Because I can tell you that this dip is going to go a lot deeper. Unless some magical powers that be just come in and just buy up, you know, $500 billion worth of Bitcoin. And also, if the charts look a little like, you could change it to line. Do you see which way we're going, right? People that are new are like, oh, I get it. Like, I should not be buying in this area. Okay, that's good. How about we just change it to a Heikin-Ashi? This is pretty clear, right? You're like, no. Bitcoin's the, I get, guys, if there's ever anything that I fall in love with, it is the corn. And then everyone in the Facebook, on my stock, you know, dominate stocks, Facebook group, they're like, buy the dip. Guys, no, you have to wait for confirmation. That's what you do. You just wait. Oh, does it bounce off of this? Does this change? Is there anything that is changing? No. I fought with so many gold friends. I love gold. I love gold. I love silver. I love stock. Well, stocks, and then you just trade them. I love Bitcoin. I love, you know, crypto. but you gotta have some wisdom. And if you come into this with a mentality of, well, I'm just gonna accumulate. Okay, that's great. Do you wanna accumulate at 3,500 or do you wanna accumulate at 65,000? I sound a little drunk on that one. I promise, this is all I'm drinking right here. And it's not even sponsored. And also, I hate doing these videos. Anything that I do, because I get ripped on both sides, right? People are like, oh, ha, ha, you said Bitcoin was going to go to 100,000. I'm like, there's a high probability that within, right? There still is. But we are at the bottom of the 16th inning, and Bitcoin is down by 20. And here, let me give you some other horrific TA, just since I got you on the screen. Do you guys know what this is forming right here? Yeah? No, that's not good. That's called a bear pennant, right? And I use this against Kathy Woods. And then guess which way? No. I mean, if it breaks to that, like, oh my, congratulations, okay? You win. And I feel terrible telling you guys all of this, but it's almost like being at a wedding and you're like, yeah, I just don't see this, right? You're sitting there and you're probably maybe a best man or something. You're like, yeah, I don't think this one's going to last. And then everyone in the whole audience looks at you and you're like, was my mic on? And let me just tell you this. These charts, weeks ago, days ago, definitely I've been like, hey guys, look at the charts. The charts will predict what Patty says every single time. So tomorrow when, you know, Bitcoin crash or whatever, and they're like, oh, it's this, it's Elon, it's, you know, Michael Saylor. It's none of the above. The charts will predict the news. They have a run on it for about, they probably have like a 3-day crystal balls. But people like simple answers. Why is the housing market going up? Here's why. Because the Fed go burr, right? Even though it's completely, why would you even say that's absolutely the farthest thing from the truth? Or why did Bitcoin crash? Well, because of Michael Saylor, because of, you know, Biden, or because of, you know, there's always something. Stocks could be volatile. We got turbulence from cryptocurrency. Why? It's the Fed. At the end of the day, just blame it on Jerome. Hey, Jerome, can you stop burr, please? Even though no one's ever received a burr. Remember, kids, the Fed lends. They do not spend. Also, just to back up my statement on the Fed lends, it does not spend. The way everyone thinks that, you know, the banking system works. I mean, Janet Yellen doesn't even, if you guys want to watch this, it aired Real Vision March 29th. Lacey Hunt and Danielle DiMartino Booth, I've had her on before. And we just talk about just how the whole system works. And the Fed lends, it doesn't spend. The only way you're going to get this hyperinflation, actually, hopefully I've pegged it to the right spot.
People out there that want to create a digital account for all non-institutionalized adults so that it can be funded with the Fed's liabilities. In my view, that is a whole different regime. In that case, you would be printing money. And if we go down that route, in very short order, we will get hyperinflation. You will trigger what's called...
Laws of the regression, good money chases out bad money chases out good money. But let me explain. You're like, you're stumbling. Yeah, because what'll have to happen is you'll have to have an account with the Fed. And then they'll use their balance sheet, right? Fed go burr kind of thing that doesn't get out into the real economy. Then they start using that. You have your handy dandy phone on you, and it goes directly in. That is when you have hyperinflation, and that is when you run to gold. I will sell everything. I will sell this microphone. I will sell my drink here, anything that I got, and I will go all 100% into gold when that happens. Which, you know, we're laying the groundwork, right? We're seeing this, but right now I get it. We have this transitory inflation. It feels like it's real bad right now. You guys don't know real bad. You wait. Again, it's not bad yet. The Fed's inflation measure, and I think interest rates are just going to keep coming down. Because the banks, that's where money comes from. In the banking system, you take out a loan. Poof. That's where inflation comes from. Taking out loans. This is where it's all at, in the banking system. And I apologize that I had to do a whole thing on the minute they say Fed, inflation, I can show you the charts. I can show you where we're going with the yields. I mean, sure, you could have, pops in it, but big picture, I no. And it's sad that I have to keep going back and forth because when I'm explaining like the Fed, the bond, the stocks, the yields, like it's all connected, but it's all based on the bond. It's all based on debt. Well, except for Bitcoin. If you go down the rabbit hole, I plug in my computer, right? I do some mining. No debt has been created. That is it. I mined a Bitcoin, and that's not debt-based. Everything else is debt-based. Do you see? I can mine it. I can send it to you. You can send it back. Ta-da! It's a secured network on the blockchain. You can see exactly what I'm doing. What kind of? You see the wallet. You see the address. But everything else is right here. It is the bond. It is the dollar, which is a bond. TLT, which is a bond. This is your 20. See the bond right there. The interest that we have to pay on that said bond, when that interest goes up, stock market goes down. Like, it's all these, and I would say, I would like to say that Bitcoin's not affected, but I believe it is a risk on asset, and it is very much. I believe gold is affected, because when people click the sell button, that sell button is connected to everything, right? They're just like, get out of everything. That's why in March, Bitcoin tanked. S&P tanked, SPY tanked, gold tanked, everything tanked. But inverse, what did everyone run to? The dollar, the doll hairs. That's, hopefully you guys are getting it. Now, macro, sometimes, you know, in the small amount, you know, week, month, yeah, things not so much. But when you pull back and you can see the big picture, yes. Kind of like right here, this is your yield. You're like, oh, and sorry, it's an old chart. I don't even know what. Here, you want to see a trend line? I drew for you. Also, real quick, as I'm on this, some terrible drawings. Do you guys see what I see? That is not a bear flag. That is not a bear pennant. That's actually a bull pennant on the yield. Oh, no. Remember, kids, yields go up. Everything else goes down. But then when I pull really far, far, far back for you, I think you guys can see it. Where we're going on the yield. Big picture, long term, system's broken, Fed's broken, yields, your interest rate goes to zero. Yes, they're gonna fight it up, but big picture going back to as far as the eye can see, this is the 80s. We're going down, kids. The GDP, the economy, everything is broken. No matter how much money that they spend, they get nothing in return for GDP, except you get higher taxes. It's just, the world is a worser place. Back in the day where they would spend, you know, a dollar, they'd get X amount in GDP now, or debt, the more debt that they accrue. There is no GDP. There's no economy. There's no anything. This whole thing is going to reset. And the powers that be, I don't know if they even know it, but I'm just telling you, this is how it's going to, this is how we do it. And whether it's the dollar or Bitcoin or Tesla, when people see like blood in the water, hey, even if it's by accident, you're like, oh, okay, yeah, I'll short Tesla, I'll short Bitcoin, I'll short the dollar. And it's not because of, you know, Biden policy, it's none of that. It's just, it is what it is. Here's Tesla records longest weekly losing streak in 3 years. So let's take a look. It's our lovely Tesla before it opens in the morning. And oh boy, this is getting exciting. Look at this, right? Now, most people see this and go like, oh, short it. Do you guys see the reversal on the MACD? A divergence, right? Uh-oh, there's your 200 right there. That little blue line. You also have one, two touch. Is that a double bottom that I see? So if actually, now, this is why I always say, you have to wait for confirmation. Sure, you could YOLO. Go ahead, YOLO. Ah, Tesla, you know, whatever. To me, it's like, oh, you're almost, it's a not on the daily. This is a not yet moment. And you still have one more thing against you. Here, let me change my candles to Heikinashi. Okay, there has been a lot of strength to the downside. I do see a reversal, though. It's kind of like Bitcoin. It's that do or die moment, which it looks like they had the die moment. Now, you know, bottom of the ninth, Tesla's up to bat. Can you, like, can I push, get, right there. We want you right there, buddy. And also, isn't it cool that for those of you that took the leap and took care of your own finances, or, and you're in the course and you're learning how to trade, at least when you're out at a bar, you're hanging out with your buddies, they're like, dude, did you see what Tesla, right? Or did you see this and the news that? And you're just like, well, did you wait for confirmation? They're like, what? Bruh, what are you even saying? They're like, yeah, dude, I like took all my kids' college fund. I went YOLO and, you know, whatever, Bitcoin. And you're just like, well, why did you enter that trade? Now, that is the question. Someone asked this to me, I think it was like 20 years ago. They're like, and it was a bad trade. And they're like, why did you enter that trade? And I'm like, what do you mean? And you want to know what trade it was? Oh, God, I feel so stupid even saying this. But I will do it. It was SQQQ. I'm like, well, because the NASDAQ, it's going to get, you know, beaten up. And it's like, well, that's an intraday trade. Wait, what are you talking? I'm like, yeah, buy and hodl, SQQQ. Just when I think I have intelligence, because I know an ETF that actually goes against the NASDAQ, I then am a complete idiot. So if I was Elon right here, this is Tesla, right? See, this is Elon, and he has diamond hands, okay? See, those be diamond hands. He needs to get above this. See this line right here? This thing right here, this little candle needs to get here. I'll color it in for you. And I apologize for my crooked candle, okay? Elon definitely leans to the right. That's how I see it on my screen. That's right to me. I don't know if it's left to you. It looks Elon leans to the right. Now, how about this? Let's head back to Bloomberg with your new knowledge that you have, because you're like, I don't need the course. I'm just going to subscribe and I'm going to watch every single one of your videos, because I do give it all. I give everything away for free. Oh, also, if you want to launch a product on Amazon, I gave that all away for free. And then people are like, can I ask a question? I'm like, ah, F it. I'll just create a course. So it's like 80 something videos. And I actually have a video for free that I filmed, I think it was last week, for you. Oh, this is an ADHD moment. Dang it. I'll try to get back to that. If I don't, I'm sorry. I very much apologize. I need to turn this on. All right, so let's just take a look at this. Let's see if being a high school teacher with ADHD, if you've learned, okay, Tesla records longest weekly losing streak in 3 years. So you would think, well, let's short this mother, right? The shares have taken a hit amid incremental bad news. Okay, don't care about news. Pressure, here we go, unlikely to ease anytime soon, Roth analyst says. Okay, let's head over to the news and see for 5 seconds.
What are we seeing right now in Beijing, Craig? Why,
yes, Craig.
Why does Elon Musk have more problems in China?
Yeah, he's been on a bit of a rough run recently. We had the Shanghai Auto Show a few weeks back.
Oh, we had an auto show. Okay, so that's why. So because of the auto show, let's all head over to Tesla and short it. Probably not a good idea. And I did want to go into this, but I'm probably going to save this chart for another time, because I did all this work for you to put that free video out there. So I'm going to slash that, all five of you that are currently watching now. What the heck is my wife buying? Do you see this? What is she buying for the dog? That has to be the ugly, I am not, ooh, wait, there's like two things, right? Uh-oh. Are we expecting another dog? Like, dang it, Kristen, what are you even doing, right? You should learn about incognito mode that your husband doesn't know anything about either. And also, honest to boot, I had no, ooh, my battery's running low. Hold on. Okay, sorry, gotta plug in. This guy's making $228,000 a month, almost $300,000 a month on each one. How much is this guy making? Oh my gosh, he's a multi, oh my gosh. The green one makes $250,000. Okay, if you guys want, I honestly, as you can see my, oh, it just keeps going. This guy is like oodles of money. Now, don't go out there and do a dog leash. I'm just, gosh, you gotta go through the course. And no, it's not $997. I'm gonna leave a huge discount below. Please do me a favor. I don't know which one it is. You'll be able to click on it. It'll say start. Oh, actually, I leave two of them for you. Yes. Selling on Amazon. It's 26. Do you have time to watch 26 minutes? 15 minutes where I work with a guy and he just, honest to goodness, you just click a couple buttons. You're like, huh, Okay, I'll sell that. And here, just curious, let me click. Am I on the right screen? No, I'm. Dang it. I have too many screens around here. See, I lost my power. I lost everything. Finding a product.
When you love what you do, it's not really work, isn't it? It's still work. They still like work, it, but it doesn't feel like it. It's the most important thing.
So there you go, you guys. I am leaving it for free, but I need to get off of this boat. I can't get off. Wait, there's boats on the side, right? That'll look kind of weird. Me like, you know, hey, buddy, what are you doing? Nothing. I'm just lowering this thing down. Just me. I'm just like off into the Atlantic somewhere. There you guys go. I'm trying to save you. Can I help you? God, one of my students did license plate frames. I think he's making $200,000 a year. Isn't that the craziest thing? A kid like in school makes more money than his parents. And I would love to show you the stupid plastic license plate frames, but I can't, because then you'll be like, oh, hey, I'll knock that off. And then they get really mad at me. So there's so many products that I'm like, can I show you? But please, I left you links, free videos, just, and if you don't want to do the course, fine. At least you're figuring it out. And you're like, I can do this on my own. But thanks for hanging out to the very end, and I'll see you tomorrow.